Matching? Hundreds. I'm Jonathan Coachman. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see teams with a couple of running backs who each went over.
We've had spotty showers since about 7 a.m. here in D.C., and the radar indicates it's going to continue. But nothing to stop football from happening at FedEx Field. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the New Orleans Saints and the Washington Redskins. Former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. The numbers for Mixon last week, 19 carries, 108 yards.
That's the number two runner in the league, and you just know the offensive line wants to get him to number one because most of the good ball carriers, they take care of their linemen. Could be a gold watch in their future if he becomes a leading rusher.
On second and inches, Jackson, and his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Joe Mixon there out of the backfield, and it's third down. And here a look at the offensive starters for the Redskins.
Out of the backfield is Joe Mixon, and he was a valuable commodity coming out of the University of Oklahoma because of his ability to be so versatile. Can run it inside with power, gets to the perimeter and can outrun people, catches the ball not only out of the backfield, but you can split him out just like he would be a receiver. And I think that if he wanted to dedicate himself, he'd be an all-pro kick returner. Defensively here, you're facing a top-five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high-powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down.
And that was a nice, strong run by the guy they call the field general.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. From the gun, it's Jackson. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. 23 yards on the tuck and run.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier in this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you got to start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or...
And this is taken in for a Redskins touchdown. From 3 yards out. And the Redskins take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So here come the Saints now for their first drive. And they will be led out by their 6'3 quarterback.
And I liked what his head coach told us about him this week, that no matter what happens, whether he throws 7 interceptions or 7 touchdown passes, he's the same assertive leader in the huddle on each and every play. He can throw the 7 interceptions, just blame the football, blame anything else, and still carry himself like he is the man.
It's like you, assertive in our production meetings.
Well, especially when we're talking about ordering dinner, ordering
snacks. I was just going to say.
That's where I go.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels. Because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, there's nothing but room to run. If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though.
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
They'll get 7 out of it.
Second and 10
from the 22.
You better be ready. Don't be scared.
Second and 10. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't venture it now. that straight punt to start the game is looming as they come out 3rd and 10.
Let's go back.
Will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
On,
after the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20.
Come on, let's go. Switch it.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 6-yard pickup on the ball that time.
52 for the Bucs. 52 for the Bucs. Yeah.
That's the outlaw. Once more, leading his offense back onto the field. The second quarter, they're down big already. He's struggling. Now he escapes and
he goes down. Hey,
let's go. The Saints get a corner, the first of their timeouts. Three, three, with exactly hey, a minute check, to check, go before three, halftime. Three,
well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks.
Yeah, ready? Into the game 18, in the top
now you add two more to his total.
Second and 14. Good.
It's good.
To do here after the second. It's him to Johnson. Now we get a quick timeout called by New Orleans. Number two. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
Shoot!
Sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together.
Hey, here.
Big, so, as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together. Some consistency, something sustained. Maybe calm their whole team down.
Yeah, baby! Boom!
Right now, you're playing big. You're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts it.
Most of the time,
you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can
get it. Right.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right to 34. 4 yards, the pickup, first down.
Tough first half for him, unable to get up the numbers he's used to producing. With a guy like Kittle, you and I both know, just took a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Now,
right on the way. He's past the 33.
That's when I've been able to get him going and establish the run. So I think it's time to abandon
it. 60 yards.
And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just to do it. Back and get out.
Let's go, baby. The tackle's made at the Redskins 40.
Hello,
because the big fella
check
runs
back,
routes. It used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different
routes. Ready?
Second and 5
You're going to see me
back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized.
And this is complete. It's Allen. 60 catches for him now on the year. This last one.
Let's go.
That's back to back at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half.
Ready,
half,
ready.
And didn't.
94.
A better game plan.
I'm going to come back to you. I'm going to come back to you.
Steve Griffin. Steve Griffin.
Some inroads here to that deficit. That's kind of as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see.
Everyone has a section in their face. We'll talk about the quick game, but it's a super quick game. High hands at the throw, bam, right to the receiver. Successfully for a touchdown.
How in depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback. They want to make this hands downfield as fast as possible.
Good work, boys. Let's go. Let's go.
Getting ready for their first possession of the second half. And Charles, you'd have to think this is where you want to start taking some time off the clock.
Oh, definitely, because you got the lead.
Watch
the
shit.
Okay. Watch the
shit.
Continue to carry the ball.
rate.
Check 25.
Check the backer. Check the backer.
Under 10. Under 10. 10.
Hey, switch gears. Switch gears. Hatch.
What a race.
Carries to start this drive, and like you said, the way it's working, they need to stick with it.
Positive game. Just keep that hot. Stay in the pressure.
offense has struggled, and they try to put together something here. Just attacking the retreat.
Sometimes teams want to do that, and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team, and we were losing late in the game like this, and we knew it was lost. It was over. And a coach called,
and
pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed.
Keep it, keep it.
Stop it with 17 seconds to go. Yards on the first game. So a victory here for the Washington Redskins. And it was their defense who really paved the way to this victory as they allowed the one.
Hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the run, control the airways, right? Make sure the quarterback is harassed. This type of performance you get, they can't fashion together any offense.
First round bye as they move to 11-1. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Saints, they fall to 6-6 now on the campaign. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.